Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. What I would like to talk today is about digital filtering, and to be more precise, about FIR filters or finite impulse response filters. It's a type of filter which is fairly easy to understand how it works. It requires multiplication and additions. So I'll show you some diagrams just to briefly you can understand how they work. And then I'll show you how we can configure those filters, how we can design those filters, and then how we can implement them with the FPGA tools. So this is the diagram how a FIR filter works. So there is a pipeline here with where the samples they get in. Those are flip-flops which they retain the sample. It's like a pipeline, like a delay line, right? So for every clock cycle, the samples, they go further and further and further, and they keep going. Those are multipliers. So, and those are the coefficients A0, A1, and so on. Those are the magic numbers of the filter. So those numbers, they dictate the characteristics of the filter. Now, you see we have many taps or many elements into this delay line, plus multiplier, plus others. The longer the filter it is, the sharper it's going to be. So we want to use many multipliers, we'll get very sharp filters. It's going to be a compromise between resources and the sharpness of the filter. Now, as you can see here, we need to multiply the samples which are coming in with those coefficients. For every single clock cycle, the samples that advance, multiply them again with the coefficient, add them together, and this is going to be the output of the filter. So loads of multiplication and additions. Okay, so this is how it works. Now, how we can actually get those magic numbers, the coefficients? We have here a tool, very, very nice tool, which is designed by Dr. A.R. Collins. So this is I'll put a link in the description. There is a page here on this website where you can actually design filters, and it will spit out those coefficients for your filter. So you can specify what type of filter you want. Let's say we want a low pass filter, and we want 57 taps, and our sampling frequency is 50,000 kilohertz, and we want this cutoff frequency to be at 5,000. Let's calculate filter. Bang. You see, this is the characteristic of the filter. So you see, it's kind of rounded here, sharp, but not very sharp, but the attenuation is very, very good. Like 16 dB, that's a million times. So let's go, we want only 30 dB, right? So we calculate. So we got better sharpness here, of course, less attenuation in the stop band, but anyway. So we get those magic numbers. Now, this is the representation of those magic numbers. You see they're positive and negative, and you can see they kind of follow a certain pattern, and they are symmetrical. Now, if we capture those numbers and we arrange them a little bit to be compatible with, we put them in a file, first of all, we put them in a file. So I can bring them in Excel here, and I can tweak them a little bit so they can look good, and I save them as comma separated file. Anyway, they get into a format. We need to put them into a format which looks like, I have one example here, it looks like this, F3, right? So we need to specify those are decimal numbers, and this is the data, and then they are comma separated. Those are numbers which are captured from that tool. If we need to have this, because this will specify the filter. This is the seed of the filter, let's say. Now we go back to this, right? So let's play a little bit with this. Let's say we want the bandpass filter, and we choose some from. Well, let's leave it like this. We say calculate filter. See, we got a bandpass filter. See, it's kind of rounded here. I'm not very, very impressed with that. Let's make very, very large. This is the points is actually the length of the filter. So let's go mad. 101. Calculate. Bang! It got much sharper. Let's make the band a little bit. 8,000. This is a very nice pass band filter, right? So we have 101 numbers here. Now there is something interesting. There is symmetrical. So in theory, we could just have half of them and just flip them. But anyway, So we captured those numbers, and now you can play with this tool very, very easy, and you can get the this representation is called impulse response, right? And this gives the characteristic of the filter, and it's based on those numbers, right? There is all the math here, how they get calculated, if you want to go in detail. But this is a perfect tool to design a filter and to get the coefficient, the magic numbers. Now, let's plug those magic numbers in Xilinx tools. So I have here a empty design where I'll just open this. So there is an IP core for implementing FIR. It's called FIR compiler. It's like a GUI where we can specify the filter. Now, when we open this by default, it has some coefficients, right, which are calculated here. And if we go here on this tab, frequency response, we can see what's the frequency response of this filter. Yeah, this is the default. This is when you, if you open the fresh, this compiler, this is how it looks, right? Half band filter, exactly halfway to the band. It's actually starting to attenuate, and you have here all the characteristics, 21 dB attenuation. Based on those numbers, which are what, 21 taps, so 21 multiplications, right? Okay, now let's load the file. So let's load those files that I created with the other tool, with the web calculator. So I say here, okay, I want the COE file, and I go browse, and I say here all files. So I have two files here. Let's take the first one. I think the first one is a bandpass filter, which I generated early. So if I go with this, bang, look. Now it's a bandpass filter. Only thing I did, actually I replaced those numbers with the numbers which I have them in the file, which I calculated previously with this tool. Right? Now, let's say we want to make a low-pass filter. So I have here another file which I generated early with a low-pass filter, which is this one. Bang, low-pass filter. My point being that we didn't modify anything in the code or in the VHDL or in anything. We just plug some numbers. So this is the beauty of FIR filter. By just changing some numbers, we completely change the characteristics of the filter. Now, you can generate with the same tool. I don't want to go into many details, but we can generate with the same tool. You can actually create a microprocessor interface, and the microprocessor or the microcontroller can actually swap in and out those numbers. So you can change the characteristics on the fly if you want, without re-implementing all this. So you can make a configurable filter. That concludes my video. If you have questions, fire some commands there, and I'll try to answer your questions. I'm planning to make another video for filtering a little bit in more detail. Let me know if you think that this is useful. See you guys.